Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Debasshish, and I happen to go around the world on a motorcycle. I believe it's quite strange, but not impossible. A bit nervous right now because this is the first time I'm addressing on a stage, but then still. How did the journey started? Let's talk on that. It began on 2009. I believe that's when I got a call from my friend. He just told me to come over, and I went there, and he showed me a motorcycle, which was an imported one. And like all Indians, most of us, first question is kitne ki hai, and the second question is kitni deti hai. So he told me one thing which really hit my mind. I told you, why did you buy such an expensive motorcycle? Because motorcycle, kya karega uspe? You have a car. That's how everybody thinks about it, right? Then he told me that, okay, right now I have some excess cash, and I always wanted to have a motorcycle, and during my college days, to show off, so why not now? And he went and bought it, and he wanted to pursue his dream of riding. And I told him, okay, jab bechega to mere ko bechna. Baba ji tha. So, and then Harley Davidson came in, and I happened to go and visit the Harley store. Wanted to buy a jacket. Ended up buying the motorcycle. I didn't have that much of money, but then I have to get all my savings out and, you know, bought the motorcycle, and we started riding. Initially, it was small rides like Lonawala. Most of the people ask me, how much did your butt hurt during the whole ride? Trust me, you get used to it. Your butt gets used to it. Because when I started Lonawala, for me, I don't know how many of you guys are riders here who ride a motorcycle. Okay, cool. Wow, nice to see a lady rider. So that's my sister, by the way. And she's still learning to ride a motorcycle. So that is how, when I went to Lonawala, four brakes for me, because ass is too hurt. So anyways, this is how the passion started. Now passion started, and one fine day, I come across a documentary called Long Way Round. How many people have you seen that documentary? Oh, lovely. Karlo plan. Next world ride. So I think it's 2013, I came across a documentary Long Way Round, and I thought, yeah, things to do before you die. Right? How many people have this list? Hey, great. All should have it, right? Things to do before you die. So ride around the world on a motorcycle. And I told my friends, you know, I want to ride around the world on a motorcycle, and people say, no, it's not possible. For Indians at least, why? Because the visa process, a lot of paperwork, a lot of complications, a lot of countries you can't enter. Earlier it was, and I saw a lot of videos where a lot of people have attempted it, but there were no access, like Pakistan, not allowed. Earlier, Myanmar was not allowed. Ek tha Nepal and Bhutan. So I thought, okay, Nepal, Bhutan kar lo. Nepal mein kya lagta? So I went to Nepal, and then later on, me and my whoever is watching the videos of my world ride, DJ, is from Indore, how I met him during a ride, and he rode with me to Bhutan also. And that is how our bonding happened. Big ride is specifically on relationship and bonding, how well you bond. Otherwise, it is not a very, it won't succeed. So after riding Bhutan, so any time I ride go for a long ride, some fellow, are you've been to Nepal, good. Ladakh kiya kya? Oh, la shit. Then I did a Bhutan ride. Okay, good, you rode to Bhutan. Ladakh kiya kya? Oh, damn it. Then I went and did a Singapore ride when we in 2015. Me and five of us, we went to Singapore and back. And while coming back, this idea of initially it was going till London. So I said, "Chalo London tak jaake aate hain." Then decided, "Nahi, ghum ke aate hain. Just go around it." But then when we came back, same question. "Oh, you went to Singapore on a motorcycle? Fantastic. Ladakh kiya kya?" Well, it was just a certificate. Nahi kya? Arey, bhai, hamare ko biker banne ke liye Ladakh jana bahut zaruri hai. So when we made a team for One World One Ride, first thing, pahla jaake Ladakh aao, because you go around the world and then somebody is going to come and tell you, "Ladakh kya kya? You're looking like a stupid fellows." So it's better you go to Ladakh and come back. So five of us, we go to Ladakh. Ladakh mein I had a fall and I injured my leg. I had to fly back. But like I said, the coordination of the team is very important. So when we came back, we decided that, okay, three of them are not compatible. So two remain in One World One Ride team. So we decided to go ahead with the project One World One Ride. Now the greatest challenge was the visa process. So any time you apply for a visa, they will tell you that you can apply not before 6 months. Right? If you go abroad, US khali 10 saal ka de deta hai. 6 mahine ka Australia deta hai, which is good. So now that is a lot of logistic is required when you plan the world ride. Where are on arrival visas? What visas should we have that will, like if you have a US visa, the Central America is on arrival. You know, and South America, except for Argentina and Chile. I couldn't do the African continent because they denied me a visa. They were asking for a flight ticket and an itinerary. And I told them, "This is my itinerary. I'm on a motorcycle," and they wouldn't believe it. And obviously, India kahan se aa gaya? Motorcycle pe. Isn't it? In fact, a lot of borders, when we were crossing, they used to click for photographs. "Oh, Indian, huh? First time." So that's a good thing to know, but this is how it is. So A, understand where your route. Then you plan your visas, kunsa pehla dalne ka aur kunsa last mein dalne ka. That you got to plan. And then the climatical condition, very important. So if you don't plan it properly, then you will have a tough time riding the terrain. For example, Russia was easy for us because we timed it that way. Otherwise, it would have been very difficult. We wanted to go to Alaska. We couldn't do it because hum logo beech mein Canada ka visa ke liye time nahi mila. So we couldn't do it. But by the time we reached, snow was chasing us because DJ had a fall. So there are a lot of things involved when you plan a world ride. So 2 years of planning the world ride and then the execution of it. So execution, when we started it, the toughest road is India. So I thought, so when we were going to Imphal, there were no roads from Kohima to Imphal. So any which ways, we struggled there and first reaction, "Yahan pe aake itna halat hai, aage kya hoga?" Okay? But when we started progressing, it was nice. The beautiful thing about the world ride is when you meet people and you don't know the language, what do? It is the emotion which connects. It is your body language which connects. Out there I realized that, damn, I should learn Spanish. Because it's widely spoken, you know. half of Europe is speaking Spanish, and South and Central America is speaking Spanish. And in the US also, you speak Spanish, somebody's gonna talk to you in Spanish. And we were on sign languages. So, once we started from here, Myanmar was again, I had done this before, so it was no problem as such. Lao was fantastic, again the sign language problem was there, but then yes, you can communicate. And the best what I have discovered to communicate with people is speak to those people in your own mother tongue. Yeah, I did that. They would understand, I would understand. So, you know, it was clear. Okay, 80% I understood, 20% is guesswork. So, this is how you communicate with when you can't understand the language. China was very surprising for me because I would say don't believe in what you read in the newspapers. So China, when I was in China, there are a lot of people messaging me, bhai, wahan se nikal jao, it is dangerous and we are on the verge of a war. And here we are riding and, you know, totally exhausted with the ride, sweating. And then one Chinese coming with a fruit basket offering us food. No, they don't know you. But they see, the okay, on a motorcycle, they are offering fruits. Watermelon, bahut common fruit tha, jo offer karte the unko. And there was a place where, you know, we were there having our lunch, and the lady came and asked me, do you have Indian currency? I would trade. Ki jitne ka dega, utne ka dollar dega. But then I said, jaane do. I gave her a 10 rupee note, and she was quite excited about it. DJ was explaining to him, they know Mahatma Gandhi very well. So it's nice. And we crossed China, beautiful memories, lovely people. And it was not like what we see in Kung Fu Panda movies. Damn, they are. They are damn developed. Then I was when I was crossing China, and I was wondering, ye sab Jackie Chan ka movie mein jo dikhta tha, wo dikhne wala hai. But damn, it's totally different. It's very, very developed. And we crossed China, Mongolia. Mongolia was desert. Now that's another experience which we had riding through the desert. But luckily, again, we timed it so rightly that we were not at the, you know, peak summer time. It was pleasant enough. See, that's where the planning is what it matters. Crossed Mongolia, Russia. Damn Ruskies. Good. Mithun Chakrabarti is hit and Aishwarya Rai is a hit. So they're gonna, from the border, Mithun Chakrabarti, yeah, yeah. And then if you dance for them, they are very cool about it. Crossing Russia was a good experience. And DJ had a fall where we had to stay back. Luckily, see, that is where the planning comes in. I had kept 2 weeks buffer to cross because we are going from east to west. If we were crossing Russia like this, not from middle or something like that. And Russia is very strict on your visa process. They're gonna give you only a month's visa max. Uske baad, you know, and they don't give multiple entries. I don't know baaki logon ka, lekin Indians ko to nahi milta. So DJ had a fall, we had to stay back in a beautiful town called St. Petersburg. I've never come across such a beautiful town. It's like DJ had a fall, and we were all tensed up, ah, kaisa gira, ye wo. And we enter St. Petersburg, and everyone went. So it's that beautiful. And DJ came, he recovered. He went to Estonia. Again, they had a tough time. They sent us back. They sent DJ back because he was not carrying the originals of his bike documents, which he forgot to carry. So eventually I came back with him, and Russians luckily took us in. It was like nahi kya yahan se chhut ke aa gaya bahar yahan se bhi nikal diya. This is how the whole journey went. Lot of problems, lot of struggle, food struggle. I was a vegetarian when I started, and then in Prague, I believe I couldn't lift my motorcycle. Then you know, okay, let's. What is the latest thing? Is chicken, fish, good enough? Because outside India, pork is their staple diet, I believe, and I'm not a bit not comfortable with pork. So this is how best was the Ecuador. That is where I realized my family. Family biggest contribution for me, it was my family. How they supported me during the ride. My sister, she used to edit the videos. It was very difficult to take the footage, but I had to send it to her and she used to edit the videos and, you know, put it on YouTube. But my mom, I met a lady in Ecuador and she came and hugged me. She doesn't understand English. She came and hugged me and I want to meet your mom. How did your mom allow you for such a big ride? That is where I broke down. I broke down, I started crying, and I thought that my hormones were changing or what. So, and trust me, that is where, you know, at a particular time, you start feeling the pressure of your loved ones. I'd really like to thank my sister and my mother who supported me during the ride. I tell you, my mother, in the end days, come fast. I don't think I will be able to survive. That is what she used to say. I came back home. In 4 days, she expired. So that was very unfortunate. But, you know, can't help it. But to sum it up, what I experienced is God made man, man made boundaries. Everything is the same. All emotions are the same. If you remove your politics, everything is the same. Thank you.